Hello everybody, welcome to a new video of the Complete Java course for beginners. Today I will explain what's the casting, how to cast an object into another class. But don't mix the concepts. Casting is not transforming an object into another. It's using hidden methods or fields from the current object. If you're curious, please subscribe to my channel and let's start. First, the casting is based on the inheritance and encapsulation. Make sure you've watched my previous video, because it will make a lot more sense if you know those concepts. You can follow the video with the project I have. You can download it from a link in the video's description. When casting an object into another class, I'm saying that the current object will be used as another class, as another definition. The object will be the same, but I can call the methods from the destination class. The first and easiest example are the primitives. The primitive types with the boxed objects. Here I say that the source object will be used as an integer. This seems easy, no problem. But can I do in the reverse way? No errors, it still works, but I must be careful, because in this case, integer may have null values. And the null value are not accepted in the primitive type. I can go further by casting different types of primitives. Even though it works fine this way, but the reverse way can cause problems if I use a long, too big, a number that doesn't fit into an integer. This is very similar with the int and the integer. Using a null value doesn't fit into an int. This is the easiest way to use the casting. If you want to practice, below in the primitive casting class, you have some assignments to practice. And you can find the tests to validate the assignments in the test folder. Let's continue with the interface. The most seen case is the following. I have the interface on the left side and the implementation on the right side. I can transform, I can cast an array list into a list. Because list is the interface, it has the definition of the methods, and the implementation has the code of the methods. As the interface has no code behind, I can cast whatever implementation into its interface. I can also do it in the reverse way, cast an object, which is declared as an interface, into an implementation. But this time, I must be aware to cast it in the correct implementation. This won't work at the runtime. It works at the compilation time because I specified the cast to the correct class. But when running, Java will try to match the behavior of an array list into the behavior of a linked list, and I got a class cast exception. If you want to practice a little bit with the casting with interfaces and implementations, here you have some assignments. And in the test folder, you have the test to run and check your modifications. Let's continue with the abstract classes and the extended classes. As with the interfaces, when casting a class to another which extends it, I'm sure it will work, because the destination class is an extension of the source class. I won't have any problem. This is the same as with the interfaces. I map code into definitions, into empty classes. And as with the interface, if I have more extensions of the same abstract class, I can only cast it with the original one.
This will work in the compilation time, but not in the runtime. And for the parent-child classes, it's exactly as with the abstract classes. As the child class extends the parent class, it acts as an abstract with its extended class. And here are the latest tests of this session. Read the comments to write the assignments and run the test to check if all is correct. When done, you can check the answers in another link in the video's description. Until here, you have to personally know if an object can be casted to a class or not to do it. But it won't be usable if there is no way to check it with Java. This is why we have the instance of keyword. Instance of will check if the object comes from a class or not, if the object can be casted to a class or not. It's a Boolean operation. It will just return me true or false. If false, I don't even try to cast my object. If true, I can do it peacefully. To avoid compatibility problems, I always use the interfaces when defining a variable, or the var keyword. But sometimes I need some specific method from a specific implementation. Here is when I use the instance of keyword and the casting. I hope you learned something new today. If that's the case, leave a like and subscribe for more videos. Bye!